What are the steps to be followed to draw the sequence networks? Positive sequence network. For any given condition, means we know whenever the system subjected to the fault, it will undergo into the three different states, subtransient, transient or the steady state condition. Whenever we are drawing the per unit reactance diagram, we will draw the per unit reactance diagrams with respect to one of these states. Either it can be subtransient, transient or the steady state condition. So, for the given condition, draw the per unit reactance diagram. That reactance diagram will represent the positive sequence network. Coming to the negative sequence network. We can get the negative sequence network from the positive sequence network itself with minor changes. The positive sequence network will have the positive sequence EMF. All the sources should be short circuited and all the positive sequence impedances should be replaced by the negative sequence impedance. That's it. So you can see the first point, determine the per unit sequence impedance of all the elements. We know the formulas of the negative sequence component for all the components. What is the formula for the synchronous generator, transformer and transmission lines? We have seen. Suppose they have not provided any details to find out the negative sequence. What we have to do that time means, if they have not given the negative sequence, we will assume the negative sequence as equal to the positive sequence reactance approximately. As I told you, the negative sequence reactance diagram can be extracted from the positive sequence by replacing all the EMF by short circuit and the impedances by the negative sequence impedance. Now coming to the zero sequence, the zero sequence network is the most important as compared to the other networks. So, little bit of precautions to be taken care while drawing the zero sequence network, because the zero sequence networks can be represented corresponding to the grounding conditions of the different elements of the power system. So, especially the based on the transformer winding connections, we will have a different connections with respect to the series as well as the shunt switches, means star versus delta connection. And represent all the impedances of the circuit with respect to the zero sequence values. These are the points we need to remember to represent any given power system in terms of the sequence networks. Let us see few examples how to draw the sequence network. First example, a 150 MVA 11 kV 3-phase generator is connected to an large interconnected system through a transformer and transmission line as shown in figure. So they have given a simple power system where we have a one generator and it is connected to a large interconnected power system, and a transformer, we have one transformer and this is the transmission line. We need to represent this given power system network into the sequence networks, positive, negative and the zero sequence. For that, let us see what is the given data. Generator, the positive and the negative sequence reactance is equal to J0.2 per unit, and the zero sequence reactance is equal to 0.1 per unit, and the Xn, the neutral reactance, J0.12 per unit. Similarly, we have for transformer X1, X2, the positive, negative and the zero sequence reactances as 0.15 per unit. And for the transmission line, the positive and the negative sequence, this is the negative sequence reactance, which is equal to J0.35 per unit, and the X0, the zero sequence reactance, as a J0.7 per unit. Similarly, and we have the positive, negative, zero sequence and the neutral reactances for the large interconnected system. Now we need to draw the sequence networks for this given power system. So now we are going to draw the positive sequence network. For that, let us take the given power system network as a reference so that it is easy to draw the network. So now I am going to represent the positive sequence network for this given system. So it is very simple. If we know the equivalent circuit representations for the generator, transformers, transmission line, and we know for the generator the equivalent circuit representation is a reactance which is connected in series with the source, that is the EMF generated by the generator. Similarly, transformer will be represented by with one reactor, and transmission line will be represented by with one reactor, and similarly the equivalent system, it is equivalent to this generator, so one reactance which is connected in series with the source. positive sequence network is very simple. So if you know the equivalent representation for each component of the power system, it is very easy. So we have EG and the XG1. So this one subscript to be represented, that indicates that you are drawing the positive sequence network, and generator over coming to the transformer. So the transformer will be represented by with one reactance. That's it. Now this is the transmission line. This transmission line also will be represented by with one reactance value. Then generator. So that is the equivalent system. It is similar to the synchronous generator. Equivalent circuit. So this is the equivalent system reactance, and this is the reactance of the transformer and the reactance of the transmission line, and this is the reactance of the equivalent system. Whatever the values they have given here, X1 for the generator, X1 is equal to J0.2, and for transformer X1 is equal to J0.15, and for transmission line X1 is equal to J0.35. And for large interconnected system, the positive sequence reactance as a J0.2. So if you represent all these values, this is J0.2 and this is J0.15 and this is J0.35 and this is equal to J0.2 per unit. That's it. This is called the positive sequence network. Coming to the negative sequence network, all these positive sequence impedances or the reactances will be replaced by the negative sequence values, and these EMFs will be replaced by short circuit. That's it. We will be getting the negative sequence network. The generator will be represented by with only one reactance value, or no EMF will be there, and the transformer by one reactance value, and the transmission line by one reactance value, and the generator equivalent circuit by one reactance value. That's it. We have got the negative sequence network, and we have seen that for the generator, the positive and the negative sequence reactances are same, that is J0.2 per unit, and for the transformer also same, J0.15, and for transmission line also the positive and the negative sequence reactances have given same value. Similarly, the equivalent system is having the same value. So that's it, we got the negative sequence network, the positive and the negative sequence network representation. No problem, it is very very easy if you know the equivalent circuit of the each component. Just represent by the equivalent circuit and give the respective sequence impedances. If it is a positive sequence network, positive impedances. If it is a negative sequence network, negative sequence impedances. In the negative sequence network, there won't be any EMF sources, because the negative sequence components will not induce any voltages in the generator. If you talk about the sequence network concept, the zero sequence network is a very very important. So for that you need to understand the how to represent the zero sequence network with respect to the different transformer connections of the windings. Now coming to here, generator. The zero sequence component of the generator will be represented by the Z naught value is nothing but Zg naught plus 3Zn. If we want to represent in terms of X naught, X naught is equal to Xg naught plus 3 times of Xn. So here they have given the value of Xn. So we need to represent that value in terms of the zero sequence network. Xg naught, 3xn. So for negative sequence and zero sequence, we won't be having any EMF. So this is the xg naught value. So whatever value they have given, we will put here. And this is the 3 times of xn value. This is the generator equivalent circuit. Now coming to the transformer, the primary side is a delta connected. We know that if the primary is a delta connected, we know that if the primary is a delta connected, the shunt switch of the primary side should be closed. Then coming to the secondary side, we have a star with the solidly grounded. So the series switch will be closed. That means we won't be having any open circuit here. The next one is the transmission line. The transmission line will be represented by one reactance. Then here also we have a neutral grounded through a reactance value. So this will be represented by the X naught system value plus 3xn value. This is how we have to represent the zero sequence network of the given system. XT1 is J0.15, and for the transmission line they have given J0.7 per unit. And coming to the generator, for the generator they have given X0 is equal to J0.1 and XN is equal to J0.12. So this is J0.1 and this is 3 times of J0.12. So similarly here, so this is having J0.2 and this is 3 times of J0.1. Then second problem, here they have asked only to represent the zero sequence network of the power system given. Please follow the instructions whatever I am giving properly, so no need to confuse and no need to worry how to, you know, it is such a big network, how to represent the zero sequence network, and it's very very simple. You need to represent only the three equivalent circuit representation, one for generator, one for transformer, another one for transmission line. That's it. If you know these three equivalent representation and if you know the conditions how to draw the zero sequence network for the transformer, then any kind of network we can draw without any problem. So since we are drawing the zero sequence network, we need to consider this also. So the first generator, so this is the XG1 zero sequence component, then 3xn value. Ground line will be common, so you can draw the ground line. Now transformer, look at here, I am going to divide my circuit into the number of sections. So this is a generator side, and this is the transformer here, so the transformer. And this is the transmission line 1. So here we have a one transformer and one generator is there, and one more transmission line and one more transformer and generator. Now generator we have represented. Let us represent the T1. The transformer, if you see, the primary side is, if you take the transformer connection, this is the transformer representation, XT1, first transformer zero sequence impedance. The primary is a delta connection. Wherever the delta connection, you can represent with a shunt connection. Now coming to the secondary side, it is a star, neutral grounded but solidly grounded. So solidly grounded means the series switch will be closed. That means there won't be any open here. It will continue for the next component. The next component is transmission line 1. One reactance will come. That is X transmission line 1, zero sequence reactance value. You can continue for the next element representation, that is the second transmission line, XTL2. Don't go for the shunt connection, just keep moving in the forward direction, XTL2. Then after that we have a transformer here. Wherever the transformer is there, just give a pause there. 1 minute you stop and look at the winding connections, which type of connection it is having. The primary is having the delta connection. So the reactance value, just draw the reactance. Since it is a primary delta connection, here again it will be a shunt connection. So now it is a star, solidly grounded. It will continue. There won't be any open. The series which will be closed like this. The generator is having XG2 with respect to the zero sequence, and with respect to the neutral connection it is 3xn, and this is XT2 with zero sequence component. Now coming to this shunt connection, it is in between the transmission line 1 and transmission line 2. The first component is the transformer 3. So the transformer 3, again the transformer will be represented by one reactance. Now what is the primary side? We have a star, solidly grounded, so there won't be any open in this section. So now coming to the secondary side, it is a delta connection. Delta connection means which switch should be closed? Shunt switch should be closed, not the series switch. How to represent the shunt switch? So you have to take a diversion like this and represent the shunt switch. It is not in the same line. Then coming to the third generator is having only the star connection. It is having only the star connection with solidly grounded. So it is represented by XG3. That's it. We don't have any reactance, neutral reactance here. So here it is open because I am not closing here the series switch. Series switch is open because of the delta connection, but the shunt switch will be there. So that means the zero sequence components will not enter into this generator 3 line. So it, but it will circulate within the circuit itself. So now this is XG30. So now this is the complete zero sequence network of the given circuit. Let us see the example 3. Draw the sequence networks of the simple power system shown in figure. If you would have understand that example 2, this is very very simple. So we have only 2 transformers and 2 transmission line, 2 generators. So place the equivalent circuit in the order and finish the circuits. First one, the positive sequence network. So for generator 1, so one thing you should remember, whenever you are drawing for the positive sequence network, this Xn value you don't need to consider. Xn value will you have to take care only with respect to the zero sequence values. Remaining all conditions you don't need to bother. You have to take care, you have to look the component. For that component you have to represent the equivalent circuit. That's it. So for generator, this is the XG1 and this is the EG1. And for transformer, and we have 2 transmission line. Each transmission line will be represented by a reactance. Transformer and generator, XG2 and EG2. So that's it. It is the XT1 of the positive sequence component, XTL1 of the positive sequence component, XTL2 of the positive sequence. So XT2 value, and this is XG2 value, and here we have EG2 of the positive sequence component. So this is the positive sequence network of the given system. Coming to the negative sequence, what are the changes that we have to make? This EG1 and EG2 to be replaced by the short circuit, and all the reactances will be represented with respect to the negative sequence. So now we won't be having any sources here. One generator, transformer, here we have transmission line, transmission line 2, and one more transformer and one reactor. That's all. Now represent the value. This is XG1 of the negative sequence component, XT1 of the negative sequence. All are with respect to the negative sequence. Coming to the zero sequence, XG1 of the zero sequence component, since we have Xn here, it is 3 times of the Xn value. So generator over. Now baseline you can draw till here. Now coming to the transformer, wherever transformer is there, just look at the winding connections. Primary is a delta connection, so the shunt switch will be closed for the zero sequence network of the transformer. Reactance, now it is star with the neutral reactance. So what does that mean? Here again we will have a 3xn. This is the 3xn of the transformer, and this is the XT1 zero component of the transformer. Now coming to the transmission line, we will have XT1 of the zero sequence component and XTL1, XTL2 of the zero sequence. And coming to here, this is a star solidly grounded, so the series switch will be closed. So there won't be open circuit in the line. Now coming to here, secondary side, it is a delta connection. That means here the shunt switch will be closed. Now coming to the generator, this is XG20 and this is 3XN. Last problem. This problem they have given in the VTU exams in the year 2005. However, they will connect the network. They will use only mainly these components. You will have a generator, transformers, transmission line, and this side the generator or motor. Either it is a generator or the motor, the equivalent representation will be same. So you need to remember only the 3 components, equivalent circuit representation and the zero sequence component conditions with respect to the transformer connections. Let us draw the positive sequence network. You can represent the equivalent circuit in any fashion, vertical, horizontal, any way you can represent, but you should not change the conditions. However you feel comfortable, like that you can connect the circuits. There is no particular rule here. Now look at here, the generator equivalent representation for the positive sequence network. Generator means you will have a source. So this is EG1 and this is EG2. Since it is a positive sequence network, XG1, XG2 of the positive sequence component. Now coming to the next line is transformer. Look at here, transformer. Next one we have transmission line 2, XTL2, XT1, XT2 and here TL1, parallel line. This is XTL1 of the positive sequence component and this is the XTL3 of the positive sequence component. Then here we have transformer XT3 of the positive sequence component. And finally, we have a generator that is EG3 of the positive. This generator and this generator all together we have to join. Because generators will be always considered as a reference, we will consider all are at the same potential. We will join all the generators to make the closed circuit. Coming to the negative sequence, if you short circuit these EMF sources and represent these impedances with respect to the negative sequence, then the negative sequence network will be done. That means it is similar to positive sequence network construction wise. So if you short circuit this EMF, so you don't need to think too much. So here one reactance will be there for generator and generator 2 reactance, and for one for transformer reactance, second transformer reactance, and we have a transmission line 1 reactance, and for transmission line 2, transmission line 3, and these two will be connected to a bus. From here it is connected to the transformer 3 and for a generator. So that's it. So since we don't have any generators, just you will short circuit the EMFs. These connections will not change. So therefore these are represented by XG1 negative sequence component, XG2 negative sequence component if they have given the values. So XT1 negative sequence component and XT2 negative sequence component. So for all the values XTL2 negative sequence, all the impedances will be represented with the negative sequence quantities. Coming to the zero sequence, this is the XG1 of the zero sequence, XG2 of the negative sequence, and here this is the XT1 where the shunt switch will be closed like this. Then this is the transformer solid connection, XT2 value, and here we have the transmission lines will be connected as it is. There won't be any change with the other component. Wherever transformer is there, you have to stop and think with respect to these connections. It is a star solidly grounded, so the series switch will be closed, and this is only the star connection. The series switch will be open here. So then we have the generator XG3, the zero sequence component. Now this connection and this connection will be connected together. So this is the zero sequence representation for the given network. All the impedances you will represent with respect to the zero sequence component. So this is how we can represent the given power system as a positive, negative and the zero sequence network. I hope it is clear. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment section. Thank you.